Hi, I'm Dr. Matt Taylor from Prestonwood Animal Clinic. And today we have a bunny rabbit we're going to take a peek at that has a complaint of a draining lesion around the back end of our bunny rabbit. So let's take a look and see what we might have going on. We have some hair matting. We have some discharge, but this may not be as big a deal as we were worried about. Bunny rabbits have two sort of scent pouches that sit on either side of their genitalia, back in through here. They have a lot of production of stuff, crusts and scales that are part of their marking of territory and identifying who's who, and as far as individuals go. This one looks like it is getting kind of nasty and infected, but it may not be an abscess. It may just be more of a scent fold infection, okay? Rather than a true cyst or an abscess. Tail's in good shape. Regional lymph nodes are all normal. Yep. Good. So we are going to have to wind up clipping and kind of shaving this area, seeing exactly what's going on underneath this big scale. And once we can see that, I doubt that there's actually going to be an open abscess. I suspect it's going to be something that looks very similar to this side, where you have this kind of a deep pocket, but instead of it being nice and open and clear like this, it's going to be all full of discharge and hair and matted nastiness. Bunny rabbits are supposed to get back there and groom themselves well enough that they keep it, manage them all by themselves. It would be a lot easier for the bunny rabbit and a lot easier for us to keep it clean if it didn't have all that hair. Unfortunately, that's not the situation we're given. Before it gets this dramatic, you can use baby wipes. You can use a witch hazel pad, like a tux pad. Works really, really well. If you really had to, you could use like a chlorhexidine solution, a wound care solution that does a good job of getting that all cleaned up. You don't want to use anything that is too drying or that's too irritating. So, mineral oil is actually something we're going to use on those ears, which we ought to go ahead and take a quick swab on. But it's not so good for that general area, because you want to talk about matting hair up. That'll do a great job of matting hair. So, except it's really drying. It's a great antiseptic antibacterial. It's a really good drying agent. The only problem with it is that it's going to be so drying that it'll really irritate the area. So these perineal glands are kind of red and irritated. This one's already been clipped up a little bit. This side has not been. So I'm going to clean this up just a little bit more, try to get a little bit more of this out of here. If a bunny rabbit has chronic, persistent problems, then we wind up having to talk about going in and actually surgically removing that skin fold. But that's obviously not something you want to do unless you have to. So this is some chlorhexidine solution that I have. And I'm going to go in and just do a little bit of a clean up on this. You can actually see the scent gland is this little divot that's right here. And then the skin fold right there is an unfortunate bystander who collects all the gunk that comes out of here and will get terribly infected. Especially during a molt, the hair will kind of ball up in there. This is a very sensitive area, as you can imagine, on bunny rabbit. And if they get tremendously infected, we'll have to see what the other side looks like. If they get tremendously infected, it becomes so painful that you have to use sedation in order to do a job like this. Pretty good. We're going to take just a little bit more of this hair out from around the edges here and stop there. You can see already, just with the very soft sponge, that it's already getting fairly irritated in this area. It doesn't take very much pressure to really get it angry. This is a clipper with a tin blade. You don't want to get real, real close. On this other side that has not been cleaned up yet, we're going to take some of this hair away first. See if we can find a way of getting underneath this large mat without cutting any skin. It's always a danger. Bunny rabbit skin is so thin that anytime you use a shaver, there's an outside possibility that you could nick the edge of the skin and cause what looks like a very small laceration that becomes a very big problem very quickly. Very firm, very hard. It feels like a hair mat that has fecal material already embedded in it and then dried. Trying to do is find an edge where I could get underneath this mat. Oftentimes, once you can get under it, it's much easier to work on. This one is very closely adhered all the way around. And they wind up getting urine scald underneath this. It will hold on to urine, that mat will. And of course, urine is very caustic, just like a baby wearing a diaper too long. It can cause some urine scald where the skin gets very red and raw and irritated. Quite painful. I know it. I'm sorry. Poor little bunny. Not long at all. A week. I know it. We're almost there though, sweetheart. There we go. This is that primary mat that we just took off. You can see the area that we just shaved it from, back with that big perineal gland. It was sitting basically right on top of that fold right there, that deep fold, and all this discharge along the edge here. You can see how red and irritated and angry that skin is. It's a combination, most likely. I haven't analyzed it. Most likely it's a combination of pus and perineal discharge. Bunny rabbit pus is not very liquidy the way that you and I think of pus being. It typically is more the consistency of cottage cheese. I know, you're a good rabbit. Chlorhexidine solution and a very soft sponge. See how raw that skin becomes after sitting underneath that mat for a while. Everything's kind of swollen and red and puffy. They become a little bit more hunched, a little more less mobile than they were. Sometimes they don't show you any symptoms at all until they start smelling really, really bad, or they have difficulty urinating or defecating. So this side is a little bit irritated, but not too bad. And this side is the side where the mat was, and that's very irritated, very swollen. So we're going to apply some sylvadine to this area to allow it to heal up. No cyst, just a perineal dermatitis is what that's called. Once a day, we're going to go in and use a chlorhexidine wash and wash this area, and then reapply some new sylvadine to it once a day. This is not horrible. There are many perineal dermatitis that is much, much more dramatic than this. And on those guys, we do have to wind up using some type of an oral anti-inflammatory or a pain management medication. You could use Medicam, which is meloxicam, in this bunny rabbit to help reduce inflammation. Well, sylvadine is going to actually make this feel a lot better. There's not any real good topical that I like a lot on bunny rabbits, just because they're likely to groom it off. In this case, we're going to let the sylvadine do most of the work for us. It doesn't have any primary pain management, but in this case, our primary mission is to get this inflammation, the swelling down. I am going to put you on just a little bit of antibiotic as well. I think you will get along just fine with a trimethoprim sulfa. It has a good broad spectrum. It's easy on a bunny rabbit's gut, and is pretty easy to give. I would like to see this again in a week. Make sure everything's going the way I want it to. Frankly, if you don't see a dramatic improvement in 3 days, I want to see it then too. All right? In 3 days, you should, when you do your cleaning, it should, the swelling should be down, that redness should be much, much improved, and it should look considerably better.